This is always one of the funner videos that I get to make, and I do it once or twice a year, and I love first-person shooters, and they've been the bread and butter of many gamers for many years, thanks to the success of games like Counter-Strike, Call of Duty, Halo, and many, many more. But what about the future of the genre? What about all this Battle Royale stuff going on? What is up, guys? Jimmy here. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s. Today, we're going to be checking out what the next year has in store for the first-person shooter fans of the world with 10 FPS games that are set for release in 2019. And let me know, what is your favorite FPS game right now? Let me know in the comment sections if you're playing any, what is it? Kicking off our list is a game that some are calling a spiritual successor to SWAT 4 and others are calling a ripoff of Rainbow Six Siege. I'm talking about Ready or Not. It's a very cool looking tactical shooter that not a whole lot of people know about right now. It is a hardcore FPS. It's about a SWAT team that will have a lot of similarities to the old school Rainbow Six games as well as the old SWAT franchise. If anybody remembers those, it was initially revealed in 2017 and is being developed by a small team. But according to their recent blog post, they have been moving on to the animation phases recently. So I had to put my money on it. I would say we're going to be getting our hands on this game in 2019. If you've been itching for a super tactical FPS game, definitely look into Ready or Not. At number 9, we have Dying Light 2. Now, Dying Light was a surprise hit that took a unique spin on the zombie genre by adding things like parkour mechanics and a more detailed day-night cycle to force you to play smarter than just running around killing zombies. Dying Light 2 was officially announced at E3 2018, and while there was no release date attached to it, the fact that so much of it was shown off pretty much tells us it's coming in 2019. If I were to guess, I would say this game is going to be coming out in spring, probably around April or May. The reveal of it showed off a lot of new features that will be coming to the sequel, such as refined movement, more combat options, and a much more detailed dialogue and choice system to make it more of an RPG, I guess, than a straightforward zombie game. It's going to be interesting when it actually comes out. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 8, we have Wolfenstein Youngblood. The rebooted Wolfenstein series started back in 2014 with Wolfenstein The New Order, which actually took people by surprise with a really good story, it was good. It had engaging characters and it had really, really good gameplay that allowed you to either run in guns blazing or take a more stealthy approach. And both ends of the spectrum were actually pretty polished. The sequel, Wolfenstein The New Colossus, wasn't quite as good as the first game, but a lot of people still loved it. So naturally, tons of people are looking forward to the conclusion of the trilogy. And at E3 2018, Bethesda announced a spin-off game called Wolfenstein Youngblood, which will have you playing as the children of the main character and feature co-op gameplay about 20 years after the events of The New Colossus. So while it may not be the Wolfenstein 3 that we're hoping for, it is definitely going to be a good way to hold us over until we get that proper sequel. At number 4, and this one's a bit of wishful thinking, but I'm putting it here anyway, okay? Metroid Prime 4. The Metroid Prime series is one of the best of all time, with the first two games being two of the best games the GameCube had to offer back in the day. However, the series was pretty much abandoned after Metroid Prime 3 was released for the Wii in 2017. However, at E3 2017, Nintendo announced that Metroid Prime 4 was indeed in development for the Switch, although they are yet to actually say anything else about it. So while we know next to nothing about it, I'm willing to bet we're going to get it next year. Think about it. The game was announced in 2017, so chances are we'll get some gameplay and additional info about it at E3 2019. Then it will probably be slated for a holiday release at the same year, I would think, or at least I hope. At number 6, and this is one I'm excited for, Metro Exodus. The Metro series is a pretty interesting one that a lot of people sleep on. The first game, Metro 2033, was released in early 2010. It was an FPS survival horror game that told the story of a world after a nuclear war covered the Earth's surface in radiation and turned animals into mutated monsters, which sent all the surviving humans to live underground in a desperate fight for survival. The sequel, Metro The Last Light, was released 3 years later, but it's been over 5 years since a new game was released since that one, and thankfully, that wait is over. Well, it's almost over. Metro Exodus is currently set for a February 2019 release. We'll have you attempting to travel across the surface world, for a new home, featuring the blend of FPS combat and survival horror elements that the franchise is known and loved for. At number 5, we have Witchfire. The recent popularity of more old-school FPS games like Doom and Shadow Warrior have caused a lot of developers to realize that there is a market for games like this one, which is excellent since we're going to be getting another one next year in the form of Witchfire. Now, Witchfire is a very dark, very fast-paced shooter from the developers of Painkiller and Bulletstorm, and it's going to feature a ton of cool weapons, abilities, and monsters to slay by the hundreds. There have been some pretty limited information leaks on the game so far, but we've gotten some gameplay, and I'm willing to bet we're going to get a full reveal and release date at E3 2019 and a release by the end of the year. So definitely keep an eye out for this one. At number 4, we have Rage 2. The first Rage game was released in 2010, and it was praised for everything. Its visuals, its combat, well, not everything. It was criticized for the story and maybe a little bit of repetitive gameplay, but thankfully, it seems Bethesda and ID Software have taken the criticism to heart, because everything we've seen for the sequel, Rage 2, looks like it is shaping up to be a complete correction of the first game's flaws, which, that's how you're supposed to do it. If you mess up, listen to the community and fix it. It will keep the great combat and visuals, but add new abilities, a more coherent story, and much more replay value, thank goodness. Rage 2 is currently slated for a quarter 2 release in 2019. Now, that doesn't mean anything in any of these what we're talking about that they have said are coming out with set release dates. Remember, there is always the chance that they push them back or delay them, which has become a pretty common practice in video game development. At number 3, we have a game that isn't technically confirmed yet, but I think we all know it's coming. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 4. Now, Call of Duty's yearly cycle is moving right along next year, and guess what? Infinity Ward is back up to bat. Now, IW hasn't really been stellar with their last couple games. There have been tons of leaks coming out over the last few months suggesting that their next game is going to be Modern Warfare 4, and that a lot of the original MW developers have returned to the company to work for it. If that is the case, my friends, I'm going to be pretty excited. I know a lot of other people will as well. COD fans have been begging for a modern day game for years now. While Black Ops 4 is solid, it's been a long time since we've had the traditional boots on the ground COD game in the Modern Warfare era. And hopefully this is it, and hopefully they get it right. At number 2, we have, well, it's not exactly a game, it's a game mode. Battlefield 5 Firestorm. Now, Battlefield 5 is set for release very, very soon. By the time you watch this video, it may be out. It's a highly anticipated game, but it also has a highly anticipated Battle Royale mode that isn't set to launch until March of 2019. It's obviously clear that it's not ready, okay? Now, we don't know if it's going to be available separately or if people that get Battlefield 5 will get it automatically, but I do know a lot of people are very interested to see what DICE can do with their Battle Royale concept. Ever since the BR craze started, people have been saying that Battlefield should do a BR since they're already the masters of large-scale combat. We're finally gonna get it. I just wish it was sooner. And what could be better? Instead of having a storm or a toxic gas cloud, you're gonna have this giant ring of fire. And finally, and this is one that I am most looking forward to, Doom Eternal. Was there ever any doubt that this was going to be number one today? The 2016 Doom reboot was a surprisingly excellent first-person shooter that was a faithful modernization of the original game's mechanics, with the addition of other cool things like weapon mods, double jumping, finishing moves, light RPG elements, and a lot more. The game was awesome. Personally, I don't think we're actually going to get an announcement of a sequel at this year's E3, but Bethesda surprised us by giving us a cinematic trailer, and then at QuakeCon, they gave us a whole half hour of gameplay, and the game looks amazing. You can see it on the screen here. It's basically just the first game, but with even more mobility options and combat mechanics. Now, Doom Eternal doesn't currently have a specific release date, but we know that it is coming in 2019, somewhere in that year, so definitely keep your eyes open for the release date. If I had to guess, I'm going to guess and say it's going to be sometime probably around the holiday season. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 FPS games that are either slated or predicted to come out in 2019. Off this list, I want you to take two of them, the two that you are most looking forward to on this list. And I'm going to do it myself as well. I do want to see Ready or Not. I think that's going to be pretty cool. But if it was me, I'm going to go with Metro Exodus. I'm going to cheat. I'm going to do 3. I'm going to go with Call of Duty Modern Warfare 4, Metro Exodus, and Doom Eternal. You let me know, guys. Drop a like if you enjoyed the video. Make sure you're subscribed, and I'll see you soon.